Hey everybody, I hope that you're having a fabulous week so far. I want to continue our series on living with brilliant balance. And today I'm going to focus on how to maintain balance with regard to your career. That can sometimes be the hardest place that we have for maintaining balance. So make sure that you know the difference between your career, your job, and your calling. Sometimes they're the same and sometimes they're not. What you're doing right now may, for example, be a job, but in the job, you can do some things that are related to your calling. Sometimes you're building your career as you're still working at a job. So knowing the difference between those is very important to know what you need to do with regard to balancing them, because sometimes they can harmonize and sometimes they can conflict with one another. And you need to know your priorities with regard to those so you'll know how to balance them. And the important thing behind all of this is knowing how to define success. Success does not mean becoming famous, making a lot of money, or being the boss. Success actually means how well you respond in integrity to your calling, not necessarily your job and not necessarily your career. What is your calling? And if you're responding well to that, if you're being obedient in faith to what you're called to do, then you are truly successful, because that lasts forever and your job or your career will not. So your who, why, and how will charge the impact of what you do. So you need to make sure you focus on who you are and how you do what you do and why you're doing it. If you do those things, then what you're doing will have the right kind of impact. If you do things for the wrong reasons, with the wrong attitude, and in the wrong way, then that will impact what you're doing in a negative way. So who you are means more than just what you do or what your job is. So be legacy-minded. Edward Box got a tower on in Lake Wales, and it's got a great garden around it. He's got this beautiful tower built with carillon bells that toll the hour every hour. And in his garden, his legacy motto is, make the world a better place because you are in it. So this is what we need to do to build a legacy wherever we are, no matter what it is that we're doing. Make sure that you make your world, whether it's your world in the office right now, your world at home with your kids, your world in your career or your calling, your world may be your volunteer work at church. Whatever your world is in this moment, today, in this hour, then make the world around you, all the people's lives, better because you are in them. So you need to also set priorities in order to take care of your career balance. Know what things are most important, not just most urgent. Make sure that you know the things that only you can do, and we've talked about that already in this series, but make sure that you're also layering the small things around your main things, around your why, and not the other way around, not letting those urgent things overwhelm the main big things. So make sure that you are taking care of your life according to the things that are most important in your life. Schedule deep work when you're making your schedule. My printer is making noise in the background. I'm getting ready for a conference tomorrow, so I'm trying to schedule and layer things at the same time. So you're right, I have something making noise in the background. So actually, you need to set priorities to know what things are going to be most important and make sure that you're layering things correctly. And by doing that, you need to know when your focus time is. When can you do your deep work? Now, Cal Newport has a book on deep work, and in it, he says every time you get a distraction and you move away from that focused thinking, you are taking an actual 20 minutes longer to get back into your deep train of thought and do your creative deep work thinking. So if you're in the midst of doing deep work for your career or your calling, you need to make sure that you don't let any distractions interrupt that. And schedule that time when you're able to do your best focused work. And then you can layer your small things, your less deep thinking activities around those times that you need to protect and guard fiercely. J.K. Rowling actually said, guard your work time. She said, be fierce about it. So make sure that, I think she even says, be ruthless about your writing days is the actual quote from her. So make sure that you're being careful about protecting your deep work time. And don't allow, when you're at work with other people, Make sure you don't let other people's issues contaminate your character. Err on the side of grace with your attitude, but then set healthy boundaries. You can be firm with boundaries without having it change your heart. So make sure that you think about that other person maybe responding in woundedness or self-protection or fear, but that doesn't mean you have to always bend to what they think they need to do or change your attitude according to their behavior. So try to protect your attitude and your heart and your integrity, but set healthy boundaries. And next time we will be talking about relationships and maintaining healthy balance with those, and that will definitely include boundaries. So I hope you have a fabulous and blessed week. I'm so glad to see all of you here. I look forward to responding to your comments. And if you have any specific things that you want me to answer with regard to balancing your career in your life, feel free to put them in the comments here or on my website at divineencouragement.com. Like I said, I am heading off to Realm Makers, a speculative fiction conference tomorrow morning. So I will be answering the best I can while I'm away from home. But I look forward to chatting with you. I hope you have a fantastic and blessed week, and I look forward to seeing you all again. Bye-bye.